coming out of his ear hole. Looks like he's ready to fight. The Cuban team back up to bat.
14-pound black middleweight at 71 kilograms. Well, the Cuban team at 19-1, 9-0 in the second round, 1-0 today against Germany as Venette defeated Sulo. And there you get a look at 24-year-old Juan Lemus, the 1991 world champion. He defeated Israel Akop Kohian, 26-11, a 1991 Pan American Games champion. And there is Marcus Beyer of Germany, 21 years of age. He was a winner in round number one against Cilio Figota, 16-2.
And he looked good doing it. Well,
and our referee, as you had mentioned so eloquently, Ferdy, there he is, Osvaldo Beesball, the theatrical Beesball. He thinks he's a matador.
Oh, and a ballet dancer, too. He definitely has balletic style. He has a beautiful classical style of ballet, and he controls a bout.
Ferdy, we mentioned it would be interesting as the fights progressed how Cuba and Germany would match up against each other. The German team 18-3, 7-3 in the second round. Cuba 19-1, 9-0 in the second round. Earlier today, Venette over Tsulo. And once again, it should be the speed and strength of Lemus that could be the difference.
Well, let's see how you get started.
Lemus defeated Arkady Topov of the unified team 11-0 on Monday. And referee Beesball once again destroying the flow of a fight with his 10-second dissertation on a caution.
He's calm.
Look at the broad back of Lemus.
The way the Cuban team gathers that t-shirt in the back makes it even look bigger. They all must have bought Fidel's t-shirts and dyed them red because they're huge, and then they group them in the back, and you can see the back. Look at the punches. Nothing landed, by the way, but they're spectacular from out there. Now, he's having more trouble than the other fighter a little while ago because Byers has a lot more ring savvy. He's tying him up. He's not letting him be flashy and cute from outside. When he gets inside, he grabs him, frustrates him. It's not going good for Lemus here. It's not going bad, but he's not fighting the Cuban fight, which is outside landing combinations. Watch. Dumping. He's got so many moves. He's getting to look like Reggie Van Gleason III. You're too young to know about that. But well, look at this. See what I'm saying?
Yeah,
as soon as he gets going, boom, here comes the vice.
Beyer just holding on, as you mentioned there, Ferdy. That was a good shot on our screen.
Watch this.
Midway point of round number one. 1991 was the first year that Lemus fought in the light middleweight category. He had been a welterweight prior to that.
Look at Beyer. Look what he's doing. That's not nice.
And Lemus is trying to fight out of it. And referee Osvaldo Beesball of Argentina.
Oh,
and look at that. Lemus says, don't hold that.
What an uppercut that was. It was bip, bip, and an inside uppercut just as he was leaning down. That is good boxing. Oh, my God. Mr. Beesball is going to give an extra 30 seconds by typing his through housekeeping.
Well, Lemus said you want to come in head first and try to hold on. Here's an uppercut.
Here's what happens when you do that. See, look at Lemus bouncing up, trying to break that hold. Just needs a little room to punch, and when he gets it, devastation.
And basically, this is how the German team advanced through the first round, just holding on. But against the Cubans, they're just too skilled.
You don't punch in the back. I'm telling you. That's Mr. Beesball.
The one fighter from the German team with movement.
See, that's what I like.
Taves.
That's what I like about the Cubans. Don't watch him. He doesn't waste time. When he gets his hands free, he punches. You don't give them a scintilla of a chance. Uh-oh, it might be the nose.
A second standing eight count.
It might be the nose. The way he walked over, he's in pain from something. Look, the nose. Something.
And it is being stopped. Yeah, look at the nose of
Yeah.
Marcus Meyer of Germany.
When a guy turns his back and walks away like that, he's in a lot of pain. And something as usually is a broken nose.
2 minutes and 55 seconds of round number one. The referee stops the contest. And Juan Lemus of Cuba, a winner.
A lot of pain there, etched on his face. And it doesn't help to blow your nose because it comes out into the sinuses and blows up your eyes. That's one of those Angelo Dundee exhortations. Do not blow your nose. And look at that. They rub them with a towel. That hurts even worse.
Marcus Bayer of Germany hammered in round one by an uppercut from Juan Lemus. It was 7-1 Lemus at the time of the stoppage. And Juan Lemus, a winner, as the referee stops the contest at 2:55 of round number one. Lemus, a winner, he advances in the light middleweight category. And here we get a look at the explosiveness of Lemus.
Ooh, 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 ooh. Ouch, ouch.
Cuban dominance continues.
What a perfect shot of what an uppercut should be.
Well, my Cuban team just rolls along, Ferdy.
Right, this was the second uppercut in which he touched the nose, and the nose exploded in pain, and that was the end of that.